All right. I have to.
I know you. What are you going to do for
showing? I can always use my phone. That's what I've been doing anyway. Do you hear anything?
No.
It may be somebody trying to dial in.
Rabbi Green, you have returned.
Yes, all right.
Now you're back on. Let's see where everyone else is.
Okay.
Who's missing?
Somebody else is back on by phone.
That's I think Bob Bromberg.
Right, could be. Okay.
Teddy signed off. He forgot. So I'll call Teddy and tell him to go on.
Yeah. Okay.
And while I have you here, what four parshas are still open?
They're all taken.
Oh, okay, good. I don't have to.
You're welcome to learn whatever you'd like on your own as well.
Oh, I can learn Shabbos. It's easy.
Okay.
All right. Let me go. Let me call Ted and tell him to go back on. Someone just signed on. Oh, Bromberg's back.
Yeah. So it's somebody else by phone then.
Yeah, Ted. I'll see if I can call him.
I'm not sure what happened.
I think I do. I'll tell you afterwards.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, Bob. Ted, get off. Oh, he's on the phone. Ted, it's Harvey. Well, you're on the phone probably. But anyway, go back into Zoom, okay? Try it now.
Well, we're gonna switch. We'll wait one more minute or so and then we'll pick up, okay? I'm not sure what the whole problem was, but
I don't think he released you as the host. That was the problem.
No, I get something different than my.
Tell Ted to go back in. It should work now. Go back in. Okay. All right. Thank you. All right, so maybe Ted will come back in now. Erwin's still not there. What happened to Erwin? Erwin disappeared.
Okay. All right, we'll wait another moment. If Ted's gonna get back on. Maybe Erwin will get back on. 718-208-3628. That must be
That's probably Erwin.
That could be Erwin, I don't know. Okay. There's Ted. All right, Ted. Glad you could join us back. Okay, I'm going to start back up again. All right, I'm going to start again from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, about 6 lines from the top of Amud Beis, Ayin Bet Amud Beis. This is remember we just got through the point where the Rava said he was Patur, Abai said he was Chayav, and Rava is now going to give his explanation why he held that way. In this situation of accidentally cutting something where the intent was simply to lift it, okay? Pick something up, okay? Rabba Amar Patur, he says he's exempt, right? Daha lo nitkaven l'chaticha de'isura, because his intent was not to perform a prohibited kind of cutting. Abai Amar Chayav, Abai says he is obligated. Daha k'mechaven l'chaticha ba'amah, because his intent was in general to cut. And since it fulfilled his intent of cutting, that's why Abai holds that he is chayav. Amar Rav Amina Aminala, on what basis do I know this? He says, D'Tanya. Coming back now, D'Tanya is taught in a brighter. Chomer Shabbat Misha'a Mitzvot. There's stringency with regards to Shabbos more than other commandments. B'chomer Sha'ar Mitzvot Mishabbat. And there's stringency with regards to other commandments more than Shabbat. Now, Chomer Shabbat Mishar Mitzvot, the stringency regarding Shabbat more than the other mitzvot, Shahashabbat Asa Shtayim Ba'alem Echad, that according to the case, if on Shabbat he performs two different kinds of labors in a single unawareness, Chayav Al Kol Echad Ba'echad. He is obligated on each and every one of the labors, okay? Each separately. Ma she'ein kein b'sha'ar mitzvot, which is not the case in regards to other mitzvahs. V'chomer sha'ar mitzvot mishabbat, and the stringency regarding other commandments as opposed to Shabbat, namely the following, okay? Shebashar mitzvot shagag below mitkavein, in the other situations, okay, if he unwittingly, okay, made a sin, committed an act, okay, without intention, chayav, he would still be obligated, okay, to bring a offering. Masha'ein kein b'shabbat, which is not the case in regards to Shabbat. Okay, going on now. Amar Mar. We're going to pause from this machloket of Abai v'Rabba to further clarify and discuss this statement that we just made, okay, in regards to stringencies. Amar Mar. The master said, Chomer Shabbat Misha'ar Mitzvot, right? He said the stringency of Shabbat compared to other commandments and explained it, right? Shehashabbat Asa Shtayim Behalem Echad, that on Shabbat, if he committed two different labors, right, in a single unawareness, Chayav Al Kol Echad V'Echad, okay, is obligated to bring an offering on each one separately. Masha'ein kein b'sha'ar mitzvot, which is not the case in regards to other commandments. Hechidami, okay, what do we mean by this? I lema da'avad kitzira utchina. Let's say that the person performed, okay, shall we say he performed, let's say, both reaping, okay, and grinding. Dechavta gabe sha'ar mitzvot. If we want to try to bring a parallel situation in regards to other commandments, achal chelev v'dam. Say he ate both forbidden fat and blood. Hacha tarte mechaye, vahacha tarte mechaye. But in this case, he would, one case in Shabbat, he he would be required to bring two offerings, right, or two penalties. Here too, in regards to this other mitzvah, namely eating chalev and dam, he would also be required to bring two. Okay? Ella, sha'ar mitzvot, delo mechayev ella chada. But how can you say there could be a situation where we might say that Shabbos is still more stringent, and in other mitzvot, less stringent? For example, you'd only have to bring one, hechidami. How would it be similar? Okay. De'achal chelev v'chelev. Okay. That in this case, he ate really chelev twice. Ate it once, and then afterwards, another time. Okay. And he would do so all in a single lapse of awareness. The kafta gabe Shabbat. That then would then be parallel, okay, to Shabbat. The avad k'tsira uk'tsira. That the person then carried out reaping and then another reaping, let's say. Hacha chada mechaye, v'hacha chada mechaye. In that case, he would be only obligated to bring one. And here too, in regards to the other mitzvot, he would only be obligated to bring one. So the Gemara says then, le'olam da'avad k'tzira utchina. No, we're saying that he performed reaping and grinding. Umayi. Ma she'en kein b'shar mitzvot. And what then do we mean that we say that Shabbat can at times be more stringent than other mitzvot? Ha'avodah zarah. We're talking about comparing it to avodah zarah. Because at times we say the performance of avodah zarah is like somebody who breaks all the mitzvot. Ukadarabi Ami, okay? And this is similar in accordance with the view of Rabbi Ami. The Amar Rabbi Ami, okay, who says as follows, all right? Zivach, if he sacrificed, the kitar, and he offered up incense, v'nisech, and he performed a libation, okay, of some kind to an idol, b'ha'alma achat, all in a single state of unawareness, eino chayav ela echad. Okay, he would only have to bring one offering. Bamai o kimta. Okay, on what basis then are we explaining this? Ba'avodah zarah. Are we saying it refers to avodah zarah? Ema seifa. I would say then, however, look at the end of our statement, the end of our brayta, that said there are times when other mitzvot are more stringent than Shabbat, where that's what it says, chomer b'sha'ar mitzvot, that there's a greater stringency with other mitzvot. Shabashar mitzvot, shagag b'lo mitkaven chayav, where it's said in terms of these other mitzvot, if one did it unwittingly, with no intention, he's still nevertheless obligated to bring an offering. Masha'en came b'Shabbat, which is not the case in regards to Shabbat. So the Gemara then says, Hai Shagag, b'lo mitkaven da'avodah zarah, hechidami, a situation where he's unwitting and with no intent regarding avodah zarah, how is that possible? Right? Ilema, if we're going to say kisavur beit haknesetu, if he thought that he was in a building that was a synagogue, v'hishtachavala, and he bowed to it. Okay? What happens? Hare libo l'shamayim. His intent was really to bow towards Hashem, to acknowledge heaven. v'ela, but rather, says the Gemara, the chaze andarta, that he saw the statue of the Caesar, right? V'sagidla, and he bowed to that statue. Hechidami, how is that possible, right? We could argue as follows. If he accepted the statue, the Caesar's statue, as if he was a god, mezidhu, then that is an act of intent and not unwilling. And if he didn't accept it as a god, right, love klumhu, then certainly it's not an idolatrous act whatsoever. Ela me ahava umira. But maybe, says the Gemara, he worshipped it, this idol of the Caesar, okay, the statue of the Caesar, either out of love or out of fear. Namely, he could have done it out of love of a person, but not really doing it, or he could have done it out of fear of some authority, that his life would be in danger if he didn't do it. Or there's another pshat that could say, maybe out of fear of the idol itself, that it would do something to him. If that's the case, ha nechel abaye, this agrees with the view of Abaye, da amar chayav, who said, right, that a penalty was would be the result, and right, and he would have to bring an offering. He was guilty. Ela the Rava, the Amar Patur, but in regards to Rava, who said he was exempt, not guilty whatsoever, my Ikala Mema, what are you going to say? Ela Baomer Mutar Masha'en Kain B'Shabbat. Okay, when Rava said he was exempt, okay, which is not the case, okay. Right? Okay, maybe it's a situation, says the Gemara, that maybe the person said to himself, well, bowing to the idol is permitted, which is not the case in regards to Shabbat. The Patur Lagamre, where Shabbat, he would be totally exempt. Okay? Okay, lo bai, mine. Okay? So he says, therefore, the Gemara interrupts in a sense, okay, and says, wait a second, says the Gemara, al korkach, nevertheless, lo bai mine, that coming back to the example of Rava and Rav Nachman, Rava didn't ask Rav Nachman except in the following, Rava me Rav Nachman, ele I lechayuvei chada o lechayuvei tarte. In that case, would the person have been expected to be guilty and bring one offering, or be guilty and bring two offerings, multiple offerings. Aval miftare legamre lo. But to say that the person was totally exempt, Rava never had that in mind. Okay. Ela, let's go over a bit. As you can see, the next one is a bit long. Ela, lav reisha ba'aku. Okay, or ba'avodah zarah, it certainly then must be that the initial situation of the statement dealt with that the greatest severity of Shabbat, the Chomer of Shabbat deals with avodah zarah, the sefer b'sha'ar mitzvot. And the second, the end of the statement, where mitzvot are more stringent, dealt with other mitzvot. V'shagag below mitkavein, and the person, right, was unwitting and he did not have any intent. V'shar mitzvot hechidami, if that's the case with regards to the other mitzvot, how is that possible? Okay. D'savur d'shuman v'hu achlo. Why? Because he thought the fat in his mouth was permissible fat, and he ate it. Masha'ein kein b'Shabbat, which is not the case in regards to Shabbat, the patur, where there the person would not be guilty whatsoever, he'd be exempt. The nitkaven lachtoch, because there in that situation we were talking about of lifting and accidentally cutting, the nitkaven lachtoch et atalush, that where his intent was to cut something that was already separated from the ground, detached, v'chatach et hamechubah, and instead he did cut something that was still attached, patur, he would be exempt. V'abaye, but as far as Abaye is concerned, his view, shagag below mitkaven, okay, if it was unwitting, okay, and an unintentional offense, right, no intent, hechidami, what was meant by that? Da savur roku ublao, that he thought he simply had spittle, that this chalev was not fat, but it was spittle, and he swallowed it. Ma she'ein kein b'Shabbat, de patur, which is not the case in regards to Shabbat, where he would be exempt. De nitkaveim lahagbia et atalush, where his intent was simply to lift up something that was not attached, v'chatach et hamechubar, and then cut something that was attached, he's patur, he's not guilty, he's exempt. Aval mitkaven lachtoch et hatalush, but according to Abaye, if his intent was to cut something that was, even though not attached, okay, v'chatach et mechubah, and nevertheless, he did complete an act of cutting by cutting something that was still attached, chayav, he would be considered liable. He would be considered required. Okay? And we're going to stop right there today. I'm sorry about all of the technical difficulties. Hopefully, we won't have that in the future. Okay? Thank you guys for jumping back in as well. Everybody,
thank you.
Stay well.
Thank you, Rabbi.
Okay, take care.